What it do, YouTube, and how's it going? Back with another gameplay slash commentary with your boy, it's Gyro. Today we're going to be playing on Grand Bazaar Conquest, going to be BMPing it up this whole game. Opponents, bad players that just don't even know what the fuck's going on. Yes, I have a BMP behind you with APFDS shell, or whatever the fuck it's called. Just badass shells, so... Anyways, we got a few different topics today to talk about, all Battlefield 3 related and all news related. So, very first news related story is some armored kill key features detailed already. The recently updated official website, which I'll put in the link, now describes the following as key features for Battlefield 3 armored kill. All-out vehicle warfare on 4 new maps. Includes the biggest map in Battlefield history, new vehicles including tanks, ATVs, and mobile artillery. Bring back 5 new vehicle unlocks to the base game, so that means that we're going to get 5 new unlocks for the main vehicles if they be... I'm guessing they'll be tanks, and they'll have to be something with the specializations, I'm guessing. You know what I mean? So we'll get some other stuff other than smoke and shit like that. Earn 20 plus unlocks for the new vehicles in Armored Kill. You do, if you guys didn't know, there's going to be mobile like artillery, also a tank or a vehicle called the Tank Destroyer or Tank Killers, and pretty much what they are is a faster tank killing like machine, but the armor on them isn't all that great, and I don't think they're very good up against infantry, but I could be wrong. So also there's going to be new tank superiority game mode, and then all maps will be playable with all 6 of the game modes. So that means conquest rush, team deathmatch, squad rush, and then what's the other one, 5 6 6, yeah, with all 6 modes, Domination and Gunmaster, excuse me. I just got confused there for a moment, just a little moment. And then also, I'm guessing the new tank superiority game mode, sorry if I just cannot speak today in this commentary, but the new tank superiority game mode is probably going to be something to do with all of the mobile artillery and new tanks and shit like that, so I think it's just gonna be a big old tank battle. Other than that, that's it about the key features for Armored Kill. We'll be talking about one of the maps in a minute, but the Battlefield 3 matches feature is now live, so if you guys go and click on that, you must have a server to use it, and pretty much what you do is set up matches so you can have tournaments and stuff with your clan or MLG or whatever it may be. But after the game is ended and all that, it puts up a link on battle log, so of the game, so instead of you saying, oh yeah, I did this up against this team, and then the other team saying, no you didn't. Now you guys have proof because, you know, there's a battle log page to show everybody, hey, this guy did bad, or hey, this guy did good, you know. So anyways, very last story we're going to talk about today in this commentary is going to be Battlefield 3 Armored Kill's Bandar Desert, inspired by BFBC2's, Bad Company 2's, Atacama Desert, and Arica Harbor. Now, DICE developers look to Battlefield, Bad Company 2's, Atacama Desert, and Arica Harbor for inspiration when it comes to building the largest map in Battlefield history to be included in the upcoming Armored Kill expansion pack. Me and my colleagues had already discussed how cool it would be to recreate Atacama Desert and Arica Harbor from Battlefield Bad Company 2 in the ever-improving Frostbite 2 engine, says Horhan Holberg, designer at DICE. In the latest issue of Inside DICE during the release of Battlefield last October, Holberg was asked by the operations team if he had any ideas for X-Pack 3, aka Battlefield 3's third expansion pack after Close Quarters, aka Armored Kill. So now, it would have been nice to see the two fan like favorite maps from Bad Company 2 get the Frostbite 2 treatment, but they wanted they would really only classify as a medium sized map in Battlefield 3, and I was certain they were still loyal Battlefield fans whose needs we hadn't met yet. Those who love to play on the very biggest maps in Battlefield 1942 and Battlefield 2, such as El Alamein and Fouché Pass. I don't even know if I said that right. Probably murdered the pronunciation of that word, but it's okay. So after they received the okay to go big, Hallberg and his team went to work on recreating those Battlefield experiences of old. So pretty much what they're trying to recreate is, you know, just the overall big sense of a big battle like going on across a huge like landscape or something like that. He also mentioned when it comes to gameplay, we here at DICE have been enjoying Atacama Desert and Bad Company 2 a lot, just like many of our players. I started thinking about the best parts of the gameplay on like Atacama could make a transition into a new map like Bandar Desert. See, now I just don't completely agree on Atacama Desert being one of the greatest Bad Company 2 maps. I thought that map was a whole bunch of get fucking spawn killed at your base. If you were on the bad team, I mean, there was no just even game. It was come up over your base, steal your motherfucking helicopter, and base rape you with it. But Bandar is gonna be the biggest map in Battlefield 3 real quick before this commentary ends. It's going to be stretching as far as 1,900 meters to the U.S. deployment to the Russian deployment, okay? That is the biggest ever. Caspian borders is roughly 1,100 meters between U.S. and Russian deployments, so that's like 800 meters less. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this commentary, be sure to comment below, like below, check out the links below if you want to read more about all the news shit that I read. Anyways, we'll see you later. Peace.